from Mexico, and she was famous for her self-portraits. Video I have to share with you. We're just going to watch the first part of this.
Let's see if I can. Do you want to learn to draw professional and impressive art from scratch that will blow people's minds?
All right, let's go.
Hey everybody, today we're going to continue our discussion on
public art.
Go ahead. Celebrating the famous modern architecture in our city.
Hey Sarah, let's talk about some murals.
Let's do it. So first we have to establish what a mural actually is.
Right. Well, the definition for a mural isn't that difficult. It's basically a large painting on a wall or ceiling, and they can be either inside of a structure or on the outside.
But it has to be in some way public, right?
Well, there are murals...
You know, I have to stop there because they mentioned a mural can be either inside or outside. And guess what? We have both here at our school. We have a mural inside and a mural outside. What's the inside mural?
Anybody know? It's right there behind you. And what's the outside mural? In the courtyard, yeah. So we're very lucky that we have two such nice murals. All right, let's see some other murals.
That are both. Folks have had murals in private spaces forever, but I'm really interested in murals that were designed for public spaces.
But what does the history of mural making in public spaces tell us? Where can we trace this history from? Do we have to go all the way back to the cave paintings of Altamira?
Sure, murals have been around for a long, long time. And really, just about every civilization has created some kind of mural that is now part of their cultural heritage. You can think about the Mayan murals of Central America, and of course, Michelangelo's painting of the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. But when we talk about murals today, I think the relevant history starts in the early 20th century with what I'd like to call modern murals.
Do tell.
So at the start of the 20th century in North America, the role of murals kind of shifts and takes on a new purpose. One event that dramatically shaped American cities, and really cities around the world, was the Chicago World's Fair in 1893. That introduced new ways for architecture and art to create public spaces that were designed to be representative of the aspirations of the government itself or the publics they serve. With the modernization and growth of cities, more government-funded public spaces were emerging, like post offices, libraries, hospitals, and federal buildings. And with the rise of these spaces and places, an interest in decorating them also arises. For example, in the 1920s, painters in Mexico were hired by the government to create murals telling the story of the Mexican Revolution and the aims of the new government. The three painters that became the best known from this work are Diego Rivera, Jose Orozco,
Diego Rivera,
and David Siqueiros. They were called Los Tres Grandes, which of course means...
All right, we're going to stop there. That's him right there. So that's all I have for you today. But as you're leaving, you can see some self-portraits by the first graders on the bulletin board right outside. So make sure you check that out. Thanks and have a great day.